Magical Babes, Adelina here, and welcome to my latest video. Today I'm going to show you, Magical Babes, how I create holographic stickers using my iPad and my Cricut. I am going to be creating stickers of the Pretty Cures from Tropical Rug Pretty Cure, and it's a Magical Girl series I really love so much. Anyway, Tropical Rug Pretty Cure is the series that is currently airing, but there is more than a dozen Pretty Cure seasons that you Magical Babes should check out if you'd like. You could check this one out on Crunchyroll. Anyway, back on topic. I saved each file as a PNG instead of a JPEG on Procreate, and then I went onto the Cricut app on my tablet, going to save each image as a print and cut, not just a cut. And before I save it as a PNG file on Procreate, I make sure to add the border of the sticker already on there, so that way it cuts with the border all around. This is me saving all the images with my borders on them. I personally recommend doing test runs on normal paper or cardstock paper if you'd like. Before you actually do sticker paper, because sometimes you have to make sure your cut settings on the Cricut are correct before you go ahead and use the final sticker paper. I mean, I used to use sticker paper first thinking, oh, I got this, there's no worries, I don't need to do a test print, and yeah, I failed tremendously and wasted a lot of sticker paper. So please learn from my mistakes, Magical Babes. Do test prints and you won't regret it. I do leave my stickers at cardstock and then I do a deep blade. I don't do fast mode because when I do fast mode, there's times where the sticker, it just cuts in the middle of the print and it makes me upset and I'm like, why? I wasted this beautiful sticker paper for nothing. So these are my test prints. I always do test prints on cardstock because I don't like the way the colors come out on plain paper. They're not as vibrant. Let's just say that. They're not as vibrant, and that's why I cut my test prints on cardstock paper. So this is me showing you, Magical Babes, how the test prints came out. And this is the sticker paper I'm gonna use for the end result. I like how glossy it is. It shines very well. So I'm going ahead and just printing out the sticker paper. I printed out 3 sheets of the Pretty Cures so that way I could go ahead and use the holo and get a lot done at one time. I go ahead and turn it around the holographic sheets, measure the lines to the box, and just cut it. And it looks like a square. Then I get a centimeter and fold it back like this, just so it helps me. I unfold some of it and use a squeegee to do that. So you see the line? And then I pull it towards me. It helps if you tape the sticker paper down to a flat surface. That's what I did. So here I am doing it again. Here, and I just pull it towards me. I use the flap that I folded down with the centimeter to pull it towards me, and the sticker from the holo to hold it down. And I just, yeah, that's how I do it. But the Cricut, it does not sense the lines of the box with stickers. I do not know why. I had a lot of issues with this, and I learned to use matte scotch tape on the lines because it honestly helps. Some people said to use a Sharpie over the lines, but when I did that, it didn't work for me at least, and the Sharpie would sometimes smudge. So yeah, I ended up just going ahead and figuring out through Tik Tok videos that you could use Scotch matte tape, and yeah, it helps a lot. Sometimes I line the lines with pen if they have air bubbles from the tape, so the sensor marks, like the little light right there, can read the lines, and it's easier to cut. Otherwise, if I don't do this, like add the matte tape on there, it'll tell me it can't detect the sensor lines. And it just makes me upset because I have this beautiful holographic film on it and it just looks so lovely. And it makes me wish that I didn't have to waste scotch tape just for it to sense the lines, but I really love how it comes out with the holographic. Go, Cricut, go! I cheer for you. How does Manatsu go? Tropical shine, go! I'll let you magic waves enjoy the Cricut cutting for a little bit, and I'll be right back. Thank you, Dreamy, for cutting my stickers. I named my Cricut Dreamy because it makes all my dreams come true. Anyway, I'm squeegeeing off my stickers and ta-da! This is the end result of my holographic stickers. You can kind of see it, but they're little sakuras. Oh, you're so cute. I hope you magical babes enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And also, thank you magical babes for sticking around. I've been sick for a while and I finally have my voice back. I was sick off and on for a while and it kind of sucked, but here I am. Until next time, I hope you have an enchanting day, and I'll see you on my next magical adventure. Goodbye!